आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू अबाउट द रोल ऑफ विटामिन्स इन प्रेगनेंसी.
पूर्णिमा, आई थिंक वी नीड टू रियलाइज दैट इन द रीसेंट ईयर्स, सी बिकॉज प्रेगनेंसी यू नो इज ऑलवेज अ फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंज. ऑल ऑफ यू नीड टू रिमेंबर हियर, प्रेगनेंसी इज नॉट समथिंग पैथोलॉजी, इट्स नॉट अ डिजीज, इट्स जस्ट अ फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंज विच हैपन्स एंड इट्स समथिंग दैट एवरी वुमेन वुड चेरिश एट दैट मोमेंट ऑफ हर लाइफ एंड दैट इज वेन शी फील्स शी इज कम्प्लीट एंड दिस इज समथिंग एज अ कपल एवरीबडी कीप्स लॉन्गिंग फॉर.
Hello everyone, good evening. I am Purnima from Fertility Dost and today we have a live session with Dr. Lavanya. Dr. Lavanya Kiran, she is a senior consultant in reproductive medicine and robotic surgeon and she is IVF lab in charge in Narayana Health Hospital, Bangalore. Welcome to our show, ma'am, and very good
evening. Thank you. Thank you so much, Purnima.
So could you please tell our viewers about yourself?
Yes, Purnima, certainly. Before I think I even want to talk about myself or before even we enter the today's topic, I think I would like to thank at the offset the Fertility Dost and Shield for this wonderful initiative, only because during this pandemic we know other than doctors and nurses, everybody wants to just stay back home safely. And we are happy that you've taken this initiative to bridge the gap between the patients who are sitting at home, couples trying to conceive, people who are already conceived and they don't know where to approach, what to do, what to take, what not to take. You're bridging the gap between the patients, the couple who are waiting anxiously and the doctors. And I think that's a wonderful initiative. So thank you, Purnima. Thank you, Fertility Dost. Thank you, Sheet, for this wonderful initiative. Thank I'm you, Dr. Lavanya, as introduced by Purnima, and I'm a fertility specialist. Basically, I also take care of high risk obstetrics. I'm a senior consultant at Narayana Health Hospitals, which is located at Bombsandra, Bangalore, and I head the fertility unit at Narayana Health Hospitals. I've been here in this field for more than 15 years now, and more than 11-12 years I've been in Narayana Health Hospitals, and this is about me in short.
Our today's topic is role of vitamins. So as we all know that vitamins are very important, rather integral part of us. But Dr. Lavanya, foremost question that I would like to ask you about the role of vitamins in pregnancy.
Purnima, I think we need to realize that in the recent years, see, because pregnancy, you know, is always a physiological change. All of you need to remember here, pregnancy is not something pathology, it's not a disease, it's just a physiological change which happens and it's something that every woman would cherish at that moment of her life and that is when she feels she's complete and this is something as a couple everybody keeps longing for. So what happens whenever you've got married and you can see our people or the society, I would say, even if it's not even a month, they want to ask, is there a good news happening? And now that the professionalism is increasing or people are more educated and they're concentrating more on their professional lives rather than the personal life, or for whatever reasons, people give importance to their own career and they're already postponing their pregnancy. By choice, they don't want to conceive for some time. And we equally have certain number of patients who want to conceive at the earliest. So whenever you're looking at pregnancy, it's better to have a planned pregnancy. You need to take certain vitamins so that you are going to have a healthy baby. There are certain investigations that needs to be done. And then when we're talking about preconception medication, we always say, if possible, please seek a healthcare advice, please visit a doctor so that basic investigations are done, basic hormonal profiles are done, basic hemoglobin, thyroid, sugars are checked so that we enter a healthy pregnancy state. And coming to something called as a preconception, that is something that we plan much well advance. And now, you know, people are much into planning. They know what they want, unlike before times that pregnancy would happen accidentally. Of course, even it happens now, but most of them would plan when they want. So it's very important that they take a important, and all of you would know, or most of you would know, folic acid. Folic acid is something, I would say, master of the preconceptional period medication, which needs to be taken at least a month or 2 months before you plan. To say that you take it at least 2 to 3 months before you plan your pregnancy, only because folic acid is known to prevent neural tube defects. What is this neural tube defects? If a mother has a deficiency of folic acid, so what happens? Baby can be formed abnormally, where there are some problems with the spine, there is some problem with the fusion of the skull bones. So it would look grossly an abnormal child, and I'm sure none of us want to have an abnormal child. As a doctor, even we want to send you home with a healthy baby. And you, as a future parent, would also want to have a healthy baby. And folic acid is something we always say, please take it before you start planning. And hence, this is called as a preconceptional medication. And I would also say in the same tone or the same breath that it's in the recent years that there is so much of study going on, so much of interest, so much of research going on in the vitamin field to see what is its link with the pregnancy. Of course, I'm so happy that 60 to 70% of them conceive when they want. But I think here we need to remember and focus on those 20% of the people sometimes who end up having a problem conceiving. Unluckily for these 20 to 30% of the couples, they cannot conceive when they want to. Unlike the 60, 70% who are conceiving whenever they want. And what happens to these 10 to 20% or 20 to 30% of the couple? It is important that while you start trying, and if it doesn't happen, you need to seek a doctor's advice to find out why is it not happening. Are you trying to try in the right period, and are you looking at your fertility period, and that is when are you trying the maximum best to conceive? And in simultaneously, they will give you all the medications. Some hormonal assessment will be done. And if you cannot conceive over a year from the point of trying, that is when they get labeled as infertility couple. So once you seek the doctor's advice, we will be doing a lot of hormonal profiles. We'll be advising you on a lot of vitamins that needs to be taken. Like I said, the simplest anybody would be starting. Or I see a lot of my patients who would have already started themselves on the folic acid. Right. So that's why I said that's a master of preconceptional medication, I would say, Purnima. And I think
folic acid, when we are taking folic acid, is there any specific time like empty stomach or after breakfast?
I got that. So most of the medications, Purnima, I think this is one good question that you asked, because a lot of times we doctors consider that they would know and say, you take it in the afternoon, night or in the morning. And a lot of patients are anxious. They really want to know when to take it, what's the exact time to take it. And I'm really happy. Sometimes it used to get a little irritating when they're like, we know it. Doesn't mean that all patients would know about it. Most of the medications, as a general blanket rule, I would say, is mostly after food. Okay, that's only because all these vitamins can cause a little gastritis. Unless specified, like thyroid. Thyroid is something very important hormone. We can talk about that again, because that would need a day's webinar again to discuss about thyroid. But those are the few subtle medications, vitamins that would be taken on an empty stomach, or rather hormonal medication, I would call it, taken on an empty stomach. Otherwise, most of it is taken after food. Coming to the time when you take it, doesn't matter at all, whether it's in the morning, afternoon or night. But we always say, please consistently take it at least once in a day. Since it's just a vitamin tablets, even if you're taking most of the days, we are happy. We do have quite a few of anxious patients who say, oh my God, I forgot my tablet yesterday. Is it all right? Of course, please remember it's a vitamin tablet. And you also need to remember these folic acids are also available in our food, the natural form itself. So which is good, like the green leafy vegetables, all these things, like the non-vegetarians, you can think about the fish or the paneer and the high protein diets, the tofu. They definitely have the spinach, the broccoli, everything has folic acid medications, especially the green leafy vegetables. But then what happens? Some people don't have a good absorption capacity, or they have gastritis, so they're not eating well. And now lockdown, how many of them are actually going out and getting some green leafy vegetables? So all these things And even like, remember I mentioned this deficiency in folic acid can lead into a lot of neural tube defects. We don't want to have an abnormal child. This is why we don't want to you to take a chance. And this is why every doctor would prescribe a medication. Of course, natural foods are not a competition to any supplementations we write. But then we don't want you to go into the deficient levels. And this is why we are asking you to take these medications. So you could take it any point of the day, but make sure you take it. And preferably after food. Once a day is more than enough. We have a lot of patients thinking, because it's beneficial, they say, can I take it twice? Or I've been taking it twice. No. Most of the vitamins, again, like a blanket rule, I would say, if it's in excess, and you are not going to get hypervitaminosis, so you don't have to get worried, it's all going to get excreted. It's a waste of money, waste of energy, waste of resources, waste of economy. So everything in moderation, everything in limited, everything in the right proportion is going to work well for you.